The drought is widespread and severe across much of the West, with water supplies drying up.
Just imagine how hard things are for wildlife when it comes to finding water. News 8's Sean Stiles talks with the homeowner doing everything he can to help.
San Diego is suffering from a major drought, and that is putting huge stress on the chaparral. Now just imagine being an animal looking for water. Well, we as humans can put water out for the little critters. You'll be helping them, and you'll also be able to get an up-close and personal look at nature.
I've devoted my property to being a good neighbor to our wildlife friends.
Ernie Cowan's Mount Whoville, as he calls it, is in North Escondido, and it's a sanctuary for all wildlife in the area.
Wildlife is very resourceful, but when there is no water, there is no water. And so I think the addition of water by homeowners is really a critical component to helping the wildlife prosper and survive during the long, hot summer.
He has multiple water locations around his house, and the animals are drinking it up.
As the pictures that I have taken show, we've gotten everything from snakes, which I was surprised that they even drink. I didn't realize they did, but they do in times of drought. So it's something they depend upon. Of course, squirrels, lizards. We've had bobcats, we've had coyotes, and then just about every species of bird that is common here comes in and drinks and bathes in that water on a regular basis.
The water source doesn't have to be fancy.
It doesn't have to be complicated. It can be something as simple as the little saucer, as I mentioned, or you can have small fountains.
Sean, this is how easy, basically, you can make your own fountain. It's simply a pot that holds the water, an aquarium pump, and some tubing to bring the water up into the dish for the birds to enjoy.
Bees also like to cool down with the water.
In the summertime, water is a critical factor for bees. What they're doing is they're taking this water back to the hive to cool the queen.
By providing water, Ernie has attracted a very special guest, California quail.
When we added water, then they started bringing their babies in every year.
And once you start, don't stop.
The key is to keep it filled consistently.
This is what Ernie's talking about. It can be as simple as a dish in your backyard. The little critters will come in, you'll be helping them out, and you'll get the enjoyment out of it as well. We'll send it back to you in the studio.